This is another MyView TV exclusive. Please remember to hit the notification bell, like, share, and subscribe.
I don't bring nobody forward in your future for me. Everything what you see up my natural talent. Mama, tell you something. You see, when you know what to please the audience, wait, it simple me.
Wagwan, my people, hope everybody doing okay, hope everybody doing alright. Right now, I know the whole Black River community at St. Elizabeth in mourning about the two young females that lose them life. 13-year-old Gabriella Maiden and 15-year-old Shalista Lismore. Yeah, the two of them drop out. They're at the river on Saturday, people. A whole about and, you know, I'm catching a difficulty and current a draw one and next one jumping in the water for help. And I mean, a bag of people are going to come say, yo, but a curfew and all water bodies lock and nothing like that this time. You understand? It's not like that this time. But before we deal with that situation, and because that is something we need to deal with, you know. You understand? I could waste them two little girl and them family. I can do it at this time. So just pass a moment of silence, because you know, so what thing kind of different over here, so I'm ready. May their soul rest in peace. Yeah, man, may them soul rest in peace. You understand? And I'm telling you, so anybody who know the family and can reach out to the family at this time, give them some words of encouragement, give them some words of advice. Yeah, may I beg enough to do that. But me have to go up on the attack now, people. You know, me have to go up on the attack. I know it's over here, so already, you know, keep down nothing and we talk it as it is. Who are the MP for that area then? Yeah, man, that more now. Me know it's a farming community. But you see, every household in Jamaica, this day and age, and this day and age, supposed to have the basic necessities. Yeah, man, the basic necessities in every household. So light and water for in everybody house. You understand? All who care for PFE supposed to have it. Yeah, man, light and water supposed to in everybody house. So now come tell the people them say, yo, was a little farming district and no pipe water and the so the people have forgot river. When people are still do a river being and them something there. Eh? All when election time when you no jump up and down and I give this like $1,000 wrap up in a shirt and them think they give people them. And the people them just glad for take a little money. People them say watch them but the one good road, the one water, the one light. These are the things. Uno, as politician, the people them put in, the MP and them something there, supposed to take care of me, the people them comfortable. They look at $1,000 I take today, I look at $1,000 tomorrow. That no make sense, so people no cut it out. You understand? All of this could have been avoided, you know. All of this could have been avoided. It's a very unfortunate situation, because this is somewhere where they normally go. Go bed and wash clothes and, you know, enjoy themselves. That's why most of the people in that place they can't swim in another local parish they can't swim. Can you notice it? After them find the little girl 9 o'clock, the first one 9 o'clock, they give up the search and the community divers them go find the next little girl body. Do you know people? May I tell you, pain my heart for no say yo, this day and age, people still have forgot river go catch water, river go bed. People still have used lamp and when next thing name candle. And them something the back of torch. Yeah, forget light. And then if you sit down and vote in people and vote out people and nah make uno life better. Eh? Tell me now. That makes sense. That don't make sense one bit. So people might tell you now. But why is the next time when I do and I do no snow when I do? Me can't tell you who to vote for you know. Me can't tell you which part or which colour uno for steer. But if uno nah get the things them have made day-to-day life better, makes no sense to no vote. You understand? When them do good, we come talk about it. So when them do bad, you know, we have come talk about it too. The other day when them beat the prisoner them, yeah, behind bars, you see, we come talk and say, your prisoner get mash up on them thing there. You understand? And then when the prisoner, they joke on them and them back and them drop out, condolence to the correctional officer there, we come talk about it too. But look for them and two corrupt one and now people, where the police them and where the government need to do with them. Two correctional officers were today arrested after they were caught smuggling banned items into the prison. Officer work at the Tower Street Adult Correctional Center and the other at the Horizon Adult Remand Center. It is reported that the officer at the Tower Street facility was held with about 1 pound of ganja. Poor land there. What's them slapping me whole heap of charge, you know? Whole heap of charge him for getting a one pound of ganja. The other was held with a cell phone and other restricted items. The government has promised that tougher laws are coming to penalize persons who take contraband, especially electronic device, in the correctional center. Hold on, I like how the government said that. We don't need to find out from the paper how them they get through to the prisoner for attack and I give such a long interview. You understand? Yeah, man, and that prisoner there, we don't need to make an example out of him. I make an example out of the paper too. You understand, I get that interview there. Recent week, there has been renewed concern about trafficking of contraband items into the penal system. I'm glad I don't catch them two corrupt correctional officers. That is why sometimes you can't hurry up and jump to the conclusion and say, them and the prisoner, them are war. You understand? Because sometimes the prisoner, them pay them their money, forget the stuff, them and then take your money. You understand? Them look think they are going behind bars, people. But more than self, me I go keep on posted more power going right there. So, gunmen on Sunday killed 2 men in St. James and wounded 2 others in daylight attack in Damed. Up until late, detective attached to the major crime investigation and Freeport police are still combing the scenes for clues. The deceased has been identified as 24-year-old Kenroy Sinclair and 44-year-old Dean Reed, both of Damed in St. James. Springboard police report that shortly after 1:45 p.m., all 4 victims were among a group of persons in Dam Road who were ambushed by heavily armed men. The gunmen opened fire, hitting all 4 persons, then escaped. The victims were rushed to the hospital where 2 were pronounced dead and the other were admitted in serious condition. So them probably drop out to, you know, people. Remember me tell you, them probably drop out to, because to all them get shot. You understand? The whole picture and they still catch you. The police them still up on the road. People them could run them camera after a picture and show in the whole heap. So we can't show in the Ken picture because we have Ken picture still. One senior police officer told us that despite all the overall reduction in murder last year, St. James saw a spike in killing during the month of November and December. Hold on. Uno can't trick we. Uno cannot trick we, because every day somebody drop out of St. James. So I don't understand what I mean by the murder gone down. No, no, no. The year ending in 128 murder in the Western Parish. That's how we know. That's what we want to tell the people. 128. We know say more than that. Kind of 1 month we're supposed to have 128 alone. Meanwhile, the St. James is the first parish in the police era 1 to record a murder since the start of the year. Republic of St. James, people, on the thing. The police era 1 comprised of Westmoreland, Hanover, and St. James. Details are a little bit sketchy, yeah? But the brother up on the picture right now named Devin Burnett, O.C. Johnny. Yeah, him named Johnny, people, don't have St. Mary, him come from. Well, then, I don't have St. Mary. Them say a license firearm holder slap him with. Yeah, we don't know where him do. But him get slapped when a license firearm holder restaurant just open. I don't know if a robbery him go down the boat or what. So me never come go in the wrong room. But one thing we're sure about, him get slapped with. I will soon couldn't know why him get slapped with. So tell a friend, come check us out. Alright, we have all the news for good now.